This week on Maker Update, a tiny car with tons of tricks, new add-ons from Raspberry Pi, the Skull of Fate, and a Rhinestone Furby. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on cool things makers are making. Happy Halloween, everybody. I've got a great fun-sized show for you. Let's get started with the project of the week. Years ago, StuckAtPrototype developed a tiny smart RC toy car and launched it on Kickstarter. When it didn't meet its goal, he packed up his project and his disappointment and moved on. But some ideas will just keep gnawing at you until you do them justice. And so he brought the project back to life, updated the electronics, and made it all open source. It's a fun little project that uses lightweight DC drone motors, a rechargeable battery, a 3D printed chassis, and an ESP32 microcontroller to handle the wireless controls and much more than you'd expect. In fact, there's a whole level of interactivity coded into this that's trained on a neural net. Tied into sensors for color detection and a magnetometer, there's a handful of Mario Kart-inspired actions that influence how the toy drives around. Hit a green banana and the wheels spin out. Hit a white cloud and you get a short energy boost. A black oil spill will slow you down for a moment. And it's not just the color that's triggering these effects. The obstacles have to be made from magnetic mat. When the mat activates the magnetic sensor, the car looks for the color of the obstacle and triggers the appropriate effect. By requiring this combination of input, the car can drive over different colored floors without being affected. Unless the surface is magnetic, the color sensor is offline. Some other thoughtful design choices here include onboard charging over USB-C, you get LED headlights and taillights, and you get flexible Bluetooth LE control, allowing you to use this with a smartphone or a computer. That said, a design for a little custom remote control is also included. You can find all the files, the circuit board, the 3D printed chassis and wheels, the remote, the firmware, the bill of materials. It's all over on GitHub. You're encouraged to make your own or modify it to take things further. Now for some news, some interesting updates from Raspberry Pi. To start with, they've launched their own brand of solid state drives and kits. They come in a 256 gigabyte and 512 gigabyte capacity, and they communicate with the Pi over the PCI Express port. The main benefit, it seems, is a notable boost in speed when it comes to reading and writing to the drive, compared to the limitations of an SD card. While they were at it, they also introduced the Raspberry Pi AI Hat Plus. This is a more formalized version of the hardware they launched in June as the Pi AI Kit, but now comes in two options. There's a $70 version offering the same 13 tera operations per second we saw in June with the kit hardware, but now there's a $110 option that's twice as powerful with 26 TOPS. With that extra horsepower, you can begin to play around with running multiple algorithms at the same time, and with a higher resolution. More projects. We've been seeing the last push of super add-on boards ahead of this weekend's Hackaday SuperCon. One that really caught my attention and seemed like a great match for Halloween is the Skull of Fate board by MakeItHackin. If it were just a cool skull with blinky eyes, I'd still be talking about it because there are multiple modes for the animations, different eyes with different colors, but also a sound reactive mode, an accelerometer mode, and a rainbow mode. Hit both the buttons though, and more lights come on, and a random tarot card is selected. You read your card by tapping your phone against the NFC antenna in the forehead. It's a fun design. Speaking of enchanted forehead jewels, on her channel, Jessica Crafternoon unveils her latest Furby costume. Behold, Rhinestone Furby. Jessica has made some memorable Furby costumes in the past, including a disco ball Furby and a gigantic full-size tinsel Furby that made its way to OpenSauce. But Rhinestone Furby, this is like your classy formal wear Furby. If you don't believe me, check out this lining on the inside. This is like senior prom level Furby right here. Now for some tips and tools. On the Tested channel, Adam Savage tackles and reorganizes his workshop storage for paints and solvents. The TLDR on this is that he moves all of these highly combustible cans into a proper safety cabinet. But the real lesson here is that sometimes you need to bite the bullet, spend the money, and take the time to make a safety adjustment in your workspace. Maybe that means moving your tinder box of leftover wood scraps outside. Maybe that means replacing your ancient fraying extension cords. Maybe it's time to add or replace a smoke or gas detector or fire extinguisher. It's reassuring to know that even Adam Savage is guilty of some workshop safety negligence, but let's also take it as a sign to make our spaces safer before it's too late. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we've got a great video on how to use breakout board adapters to integrate surface mount components into your breadboard projects. There are a surprising amount of specialized adapter boards offered through DigiKey that are specifically made to adapt the small spacing of surface mount components to a more prototype-friendly breadboard spacing. Watch the video listed in the description to learn more, or head over to digikey.com/adapterboard to browse the selection. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. If you had a great Halloween costume or project this year, let me know about it, all right? Big thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible. Thanks to TMDC Workshop in Barcelona for the use of their amazing space. And thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.